I'm not claiming that I'm a better person because of ayahuasca, but what I am saying is I'm trying to be a better person because of ayahuasca. It's showed me serious faults in my personality. I regard them as serious, which need to be fixed. And life is a journey, and I'm 59 years old, and I only have, you know, so much longer on this planet. And with the time I have left, I would like to do it right rather than do it wrong. And I'm grateful to ayahuasca for showing me where I've been doing things wrong. It's very hard to change deeply ingrained old habits, but I am trying, and I shall continue to try while I'm on this planet. In terms of my creativity, ayahuasca has really done something quite extraordinary for me. For my whole working life, I have been a non-fiction writer. My background is in journalism, in mainstream journalism. My last journalistic job was as the East Africa correspondent for The Economist, based in Nairobi in Kenya, back in the early 80s. I was very much involved in current affairs, in facts, in information. And this continued even as I moved out of journalism and into writing books. I became deeply interested in historical mysteries, particularly could there have been a lost civilization? Could there have been a forgotten episode in human history, a lost civilization by any other name? This was a mystery that intrigued me, and really from the late 1980s through until the early 2000s, I was focused totally on very detailed explorations of historical mysteries, and in everything that's involved in writing a thorough non-fiction book, including 1,000 footnotes and really documenting and explaining my sources in every case, bulletproofing every argument against critics. And this was normal to me. This is the way that I had been used to working for very, 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 very many years. After encountering ayahuasca, something else happened. I began to feel an urge to express myself in a different way, not just to write non-fiction. I suddenly found I wanted to write a novel. I wanted to create something out of whole cloth. And initially I wasn't sure what. And here's the strange thing. On a series of once I'd established that intent that I wanted to try to write fiction rather than non-fiction all the time, on a series of ayahuasca journeys in Brazil, in 2006, I was given, I can't put it any other way, I was given a story. The story came to me in the visions. I saw clearly two characters, one 24,000 years ago, one today, connected in a battle of good against evil that unfolds through time. I don't know where this idea came from. It literally came to me in a vision, under the influence of ayahuasca, and it wasn't just one. It was a series of visions. And at the end of it, I felt like I'd almost downloaded an entire story. And I came back to England, motivated to write that story. Like so many things with ayahuasca, the inspiration is only part of what happens. Then you need to do the hard work, and I've been doing the hard work for the last 3 years. But now I have written that novel. I don't believe I ever would have written it if it hadn't been for my encounter with the visionary vine of the Amazon, the vine of souls.